Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today is round 2 of the chess.com Grand Swiss 2019. 120 players chosen among the top chess grandmaster fighting for the tournament and for the last spot in next year's candidates. In the first video of the day, the game between Hikaru Nakamura and Axel Bachmann, strong grandmaster with an elo of 2629. Let's get started. Nakamura with the white pieces opens with d4 and Bachmann answers with d5. Here comes c4 and d captures on c4, the queen's gambit accepted. Knight to f3 is the main line, knight to f6 developing the knight also controlling e4, here comes e3 and now the bishop is attacking the pawn. Bachmann continues with e6, so he doesn't protect the pawn, this is the main continuation, so the bishop can capture on c4 and here comes a6. Of course, the idea is to push in the future with b5. Here comes short castle for white and c5 first against the center. D captures on c5. Now black changes the queens, because if black doesn't play this move, it will be white to change the queens and black must recapture with the king. Now rook captures on d1 and bishop captures on c5. Here comes bishop back to e2, this is a clever move, so b5 won't come with tempo, and also because the bishop was restricted on that diagonal by the pawn chain. So b6 to develop the bishop in fianchetto, knight back to d2, bishop to d7, and the knight jumps to b3 attacking the bishop, bishop back to e7, f3 now is a novelty, so the game is original, played to restrict the bishop on this long diagonal and to be able to push e4. So at first knight in b goes to d7, e4, knight to c5 and knight to d4. Finally short castle for black, the game is more or less equal. For Nakamura of course now it's time to develop the queen side. Bishop to e3 and here comes an inaccuracy, almost a mistake, knight to a4, this move really has no merits. Because after b3, and now this knight can't move to this boring position c3, because there is still the knight here controlling this square, so the knight must go back to c5, losing a couple of important tempi. Knight to d2, rook in a goes to c8, and the knight jumps to c4, attacking b6. b5 must be played, but this b-pawn was protecting the knight. Here comes knight to b6 with tempo against the rook, that seems risky, but this is the best move. In fact, the knight just cleared the c5, so that white can continue later with rook in a, goes to c1, controlling the file and putting this knight under pressure. So, where to put this rook? Bachmann continues with rook in c goes to d8, now rook in a goes to d1 and the knight is already a target, because there is also the bishop that is attacking with x-rays this knight. Rook in f goes to e8, and here Nakamura plays the simple tactic, knight captures on b5, that in this position can be played. So what happens? It happens that at first rook captures on d1, we check. Of course now is the bishop that must recapture, and here comes knight to d3 with tempo against the rook, but this is an inaccuracy. Instead of knight to d3, black should play a desperado. Let's go back one move. This position, the move to play is the knight capture on e4, this is the best idea. Of course now there is the knight under attack, so knight to c7 attacking the rook, rook to d8, and in this position if the f-pawn captures on e4, this move will give white just a slight advantage. Let's watch why. Because there is bishop to a3 first, rook to a1, the bishop moves with tempo to a1, to b2 attacking the rook on a1, rook to b1, but now the bishop is ready to attack this knight that is trapped. So in this position another desperado must be played, so at least the knight will be lost but winning the pawn. Knight captures on a6, the bishop captures on a6, this position we must assess the situation. White is a pawn up with two connected pawns here on the queen side, but e4 will be lost and I don't know if this advantage will be enough to win the game. Going back to rook to d8, still in the variation starting with the desperado, This position bishop to e2 is an improvement. Again, bishop to a3, but now the rook can move to c2. Here comes knight back to d6, white will capture with the knight or with the bishop on a6, and white is better than before. Let's go back to our game. We said knight to d3, attacking the rook is an inaccuracy. In fact, Nakamura brings the rook to c7, attacking the bishop. And now what happens if the bishop moves to a8? Let's watch what happens. If bishop to a8, this is another variation. Here comes knight to c8. Two pieces attacking the bishop on e7. Bishop to b4 is the best move. But here comes knight in b goes to d6. That is a winning move. Now f7 is under attack. Bishop captures. Knight captures is a reload. So this rook must move to f8 in completely passive and defensive position. Here comes bishop to e2 that will win the pawn. Knight to e5. Bishop captures on a6. White is 2 pawns up, and with a dominating position, it's plus 5. Let's go back to our game. That's why after rook to c7, Bachmann doesn't bring back the bishop to a8. He continues with the best move. Bishop captures on e4. Now the f pawn captures on e4. The e pawn captures the knight on b5. Bishop to e2, and this is another critical moment of the game. It's the best idea for black is to bring the knight to e5, even if this pawn is lost. Instead, here comes bishop to d8, and this is a mistake. Rook to c8, bishop captures, the rook captures on e8, we check. So the knight must capture on e8, and bishop captures on b6. The knight is still under attack. Bachmann continues with knight to c1, forking the bishop and the pawn. But this move doesn't work, because here comes bishop captures on b5 with tempo against the knight. Knight jump to d6, bishop to c6, protecting the pawn. Knight captures on a2 is the last mistake, because f6 must be played to keep playing, but even with these best moves, Nakamura should easily win this endgame with the bishop pair and with the strong pass pawn. Why this is a mistake? Because after bishop to c5 attacking the knight, Bachmann understands the trap and he resigns the game. In fact, this knight is lost. Let's watch what happened after knight to c8. It happens that this bishop is dominating the knight with the simple bishop to b7. The knight is trapped and of course the game is lost. So finally, a convincing victory by Nakamura. The tournament is long and tough, so anything can happen, and I will also keep an eye also to Nakamura's games. If you like the video, of course, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel so we can watch together all the best chess games from all the top chess tournaments. Our video is over. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon. Goodbye.